Welcome, welcome, family. We are so glad that you have chosen to join us tonight here at Faith Life Church. We're so glad that you're here.
Absolutely. It's going to be an amazing weekend. Starting things off right tonight here in our Saturday night service.
That's right.
We just love Saturday nights at Faith Life Church. It's just different, you know? It's just the atmosphere is different.
It's got a whole mood, a whole vibe. If you're missing it, then you don't want to. You need to invite people to share in this.
Yeah, I think that's something when we talk about online, that's a little different is we have in-person services, but they have a little bit different feel to them. And I'm curious, do you guys get that feel online sometimes? Because you can really feel it here in the environment. Like Saturday night's a little different. I always say, I feel like you can kind of put your hair down.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I can't, but you can.
Yeah.
So, it's just, I don't know. There's not a lot more services in the day. It's just the one service.
Yeah.
You know, so.
It's relaxed. You get the rough draft of the message. It's the first one.
Yeah.
You know, it's not the rough draft, but
it's raw. It's more raw.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
So anyway. You guys had men's breakfast today.
Yeah.
I heard that was great.
Thank you, all you men who came out. Some of you, I'm sure, out there today that came out for our men's breakfast. We had about 300 men here in person. I know some of you guys were joining online. Hope you enjoyed that. I'll tell you, that word that Pat brought today was really good. It's so encouraging. But we just had a great time in the Lord with all of our men here. Opened up registration for our men's conference, which isn't until February, but the registration is now open for that. We'll have that on faithlifechurch.org this week. So, yeah, a lot going on.
Yeah, there is so much
exciting
going on. I know that we have talked about that the Lord is stirring things up, and he's doing something in this body of believers. And so we are so excited that you're here for that, because you are part of what God is doing too. If you are here, this is your time. This
Amen.
Is your place. So we welcome you tonight here. We know that we're going to receive a fantastic word from Pastor Gary tonight. And I just encourage you to open yourself up and say, here I am, Lord. What is it you want to share with me tonight? I'm open to hearing from you.
Yeah, God is here to meet you. He is here to meet you. Whatever that need is tonight, he's here to meet you. Just open your heart to him. And when we worship here, we're going to go into the auditorium here in just a second. But open your heart to worship and just receive what it is the Lord has for you tonight. He's got something good in store for all of us. It's going to be a great night, guys. We'll see you after the service. Let's get into worship. God bless you guys.
Bye-bye.
nothing like your presence. I will sing of all your goodness, where all my fears fade to praise. Savior, there is nothing like your freedom. Dancing with the hope of heaven, where all my fears fade to praise. All I want, more of you and less of me. All I want, living in your victory. All I want, let your glory fill this place.
So much joy in our hearts to worship you, to honor you. We consider it a joy, Jesus, to glorify your name. We consider it a joy, Jesus, to proclaim your name. We consider it a joy to tell you, Jesus, that we love you.
Came to my end, you were
could never comprehend how you would give up your own life for me. Oh, you set me free from all my fear. You're the only reason I am here, right here.
With all of my heart, I sing, I love you. sing from the very depths of our soul how much we love you, Lord. Your presence, your majesty is so great. Thank you, God.
I just want to speak the name of Jesus over every heart and every mind. Because I know there's peace within his presence. I speak Jesus.
Come on, let's speak it tonight.
I just want to speak the name of Jesus till every dark addiction starts to break. Declaring there is hope and there is freedom, I see Jesus. Your name is power, your name is healing, your name is love. Break every stronghold, shine through the shadows.
Cause I know there's peace within his presence.
Yes.
I see Jesus. Jesus in the streets, Jesus in the darkness over every enemy, Jesus for our families, I speak the holy name, Jesus.
Take a seat as we welcome you tonight. We're so glad you're here. Hallelujah. It's nothing like being in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. If you are, as you're taking your seats, if you are a first-time visitor, we want to say welcome. Welcome. Come on, let's welcome our first-time visitors. They're family now. Hallelujah. We have some awesome, awesome gifts for you that the announcements will let you know about. All right, well, I don't know about you guys, but I'm ready for an awesome word tonight. How about you? Hallelujah. Well, let's go ahead and say hello to our online campus. First of all, I'm so sorry. All over the world, we get to worship with the body of Christ. Well, let's go ahead and look at these messages tonight.
And welcome. We are so happy to have you here with us this weekend. Let's check out what we have coming up at Faith Life Church. If you're a first-time guest, our Dream Teamers are here to help you. We'd love for you to have the gift of Pastor Gary's Kingdom Thoughts book and also our special Living the Good Life t-shirt. Just simply fill out our connection card or scan the QR code on your chair. And if you have any questions, check out the welcome kiosk at your campus or chat with us right there on the screen. Here at Faith Life, we believe in equipping you to live out the kingdom in every area of your life. The best way to do that is through our Kingdom Track experience. Join us in this four-week session as you learn about the unique purpose God has for you in your faith, family, and finances. We have a free meal and free childcare. It's after service, in person, or online. It'll only take 60 minutes and you can jump in at any time. So we'll see you at Kingdom Track. In World Fire and Ice, the epic sci-fi live production is coming up on Tuesday, October 31st and Friday, November 3rd at 7 p.m. It's an entertaining, impactful Halloween outreach unlike any other, so make sure to invite all your friends. This is a PG-13 event, so parents' discretion is advised. Space is filling up, so get your free tickets now at youngsociety.com. Be a part of our Thanksgiving outreach. There are several ways you can help. We're partnering with our friends at the Columbus Dream Center to provide Thanksgiving baskets and hot catered meals. It's such a great opportunity to serve our local communities. You can help provide meals to those in need around Central Ohio this Thanksgiving. All you have to do is bring donation food items to our New Albany and Powell campuses during services the first two weekends of November. For more information, check out the welcome kiosk, and we look forward to serving with you. This month of October is Pastor Appreciation Month. We are so thankful for all of our pastors here at Faith Life Church. You could fill out a thank you card to our pastors at the tables in the foyer today. Thank you so much for being here today at Faith Life Church. It's our heart that you would experience the kingdom in every area of your life. So for more information on how you can stay connected, visit us online at faithlifechurch.org or check us out on our FLN Connect app. Keep living the good life and have a great service.
Good to see everyone out there today.
Hey, you may not know this, but October is Pastor Appreciation Month.
I didn't know.
We have amazing pastors here on staff. All of our staff pastors, we're so thankful for their leadership, for their example. But I want to say a special thank you to our founding pastors, those who have really paid the biggest price for everything that's here, Pastor Gary and Drinda. Would you please stand up to your feet, give them a round of applause, and say thank you, Pastor Gary and Drinda.
Okay. We'll try it again. Yeah, no one told me that was coming up, so. Thank you. We have a pastoral team here. It's not just me. We got pastors here all over the place. I won't be able to name all of them, but we have a lot of pastors here. So Ron and Cindy are here. Pastor Ron and Cindy, of course, Tim and Alicia. Let me think, John and Polly, we have a lot of them. Help me, I can't think right now. That anointing was so strong. Man, I tell you, I don't know if I could even stand up here and teach tonight. It's like, I told Brittany, I said, just let it go. And she jumped in there. That was awesome. I even brought my tissues ahead of time. Oh, I love to come to church and the anointing is so good. Just, it's awesome, right? I love to see these young people up here worshiping too. I just love to see that. It's just amazing. Wow. Well, let me get settled down here for a second. Of course, Ohio State won. You all know that, right? Yeah, okay. I can always tell you're all happy tonight, so that's good. All right. Tonight, we're going to talk about contending for your future. I was praying. I was grieved this week. I read some stats, and I just grieved about a few things, and I thought, I need to address this. Matthew chapter 24. Get your Bibles out, your notes. all that. So, verse 6, you will hear of wars, rumors of wars. Anyone hearing of that? But see to it that none of you are alarmed. Such things must happen. But the end is still to come. Nation will rise against nation and kingdom against kingdom. There will be famines and earthquakes. Any earthquakes recently? I think Afghanistan had 3 of them in a row, right? The big one in, was it Syria? Turkey? Killed 60,000 people in February. I mean, earthquakes are happening. All these are the beginning of birth pains. Now, if you have birth pains, ladies, what comes next? The baby, right? The baby. Now, Jesus is telling us this because we want to be ready for the baby, but not only that, we have work to do. So he's telling us, hey, time is short. We got stuff to get done here. So I think we can all acknowledge that today there's a lot of stuff happening in the world. I mean, the thing with Israel is just crazy, right? I mean, you don't have to be a Bible scholar to figure out there are some things stirring in the earth, right? And anyway, it's shocking, but we are not to be alarmed. We, as believers, we are to be about the Father's business. Amen. Amen. Now, in this season, let me say this. Fear should not be part of your mindset. Amen. And the Bible says we need to have a sober mind, meaning that we need to keep our wits about us. Remember what God says, the Word of God. We don't need to be afraid. The enemy does roam around, the Bible says, roaring like a lion, but be a sober mind means keep level-headed. Don't respond in fear. Yes. I'm going to go through some dreams. One reason you don't have to be afraid is because God speaks to us. I mean, we live in the kingdom of light, so we don't have to be taken by surprise. The Holy Spirit will talk to us. He'll tell us what to do in situations. In January of 2020, I had a dream in the beginning of the year, January. Of course, I'm going to review some things you have heard, but put them all together here, where this is before COVID hit in March, but I saw basically New York City closed down completely. It was puzzling to me at the time because the city was empty. There was no movement. Instead, there were some spider webs kind of between buildings and kind of all through the city. No cars, traffic, no nothing. But there was a big spider up on top of the tallest building looking over the city. And I was puzzled, I remember, in the dream thinking, you know, why would a city be empty? You know, I just remember thinking, it's just kind of crazy. Of course, I didn't know anything about COVID yet, right? But it was locked down. I was told in the dream to warn people of Satan's plan. At that time, I didn't know what his plan was. But, of course, by March, we all figured it out. At the end of the dream, though, after I was told in the dream to warn people of what Satan's plan is, the power of God in the dream knocked me across the room in the dream. I remember thinking in the dream. It's like, can you really be knocked to the ground in a dream by the power? I mean, the power of God came on me in real life at the same time it came on to me in a dream. And I was kind of shocked by that. I think, is that possible to have something happen in a dream actually happen here? But the word Rosh Hashanah was yelled out as that power hits, bam, knocked me. I mean, it didn't knock me over, it knocked me across the room. Now, Rosh Hashanah, as you know, is the Jewish New Year. It's the beginning of the Feast of Trumpets. And in 10 days, who can tell me what happens? What's the next day? Day of Atonement. The Feast of Trumpets is a time of meditation and reflection. Beginning at the first of the year, it's a time of meditation before the Day of Atonement. So you have time to analyze yourself and meditate and to, you know, judge yourself and repent. Judge yourself and meditate before the Lord, before the Day of Atonement. And so anyway, that was crazy. Jesus is coming though, right?
Yes.
In a second dream of that same year, I had a dream that socialism was trying to take over our country. And God said, I want you to warn people of this Marxist socialist agenda. So we went on TV. We began to preach what God was telling us. Drinda launched Drinda on Guard. She had a passion to help the body of Christ understand what is going on. So we were faithful to that. At the same time, for 9 months, we did a daily podcast to help people through COVID. And then we had another dream. In the next, this is all in 2020. And the next dream in 2020, I saw that they were going to try to overthrow our Constitution and take our guns and our free speech away. I saw in that dream, Russia and China would be involved with the U.S. In the dream, Russia was in aircraft and China was in trucks. Now, I'm sure there's probably interpretation to that, what both are in airplanes and trucks. You know, I don't know all that, but I know there's more there with that. I haven't really prayed that one out. But nevertheless, they have been and were trying to influence our nation, right? God said they're going to do that. At the beginning of 2021, I'm setting the stage here because we've launched a lot of things happening since 2020. We're all not as ignorant as we were then. We now see we see a lot of what's going on. And so I'm laying out these dreams as God led me through them. In the beginning of 2021, he spoke to me in 2021, not the beginning, but it was our 25th anniversary of the church. And at the banquet that night, someone generously gave me 25 one-ounce silver coins to commemorate the 25 years of being in the ministry here. But the minute I touched that box, I opened it, I saw the coins, the Spirit of God came on me and spoke to me and said, they gave those coins by my direction to speak to you. As I held the coins, it reminded me earlier when we were building the church and different things had some tough times financially, that God gave me a dream back then of two mining carts. You've seen a mine that has railways in it, rail tracks in it. They have mining carts, right? Yes? Okay, so in this dream, there were mining carts lined up, two tracks side by side, and they were all overflowing with silver. Now, at that time, when I had that dream back in history, what would that say to you? Double portion, there's two tracks, there's provision. So God was encouraging me that there's provision, right? But when I opened the box of these silver coins, I instantly remembered that dream, and God was saying to me, yes, there's provision. But interesting enough, on those coins, there was a picture of a prospector panning for gold. That was the picture that was stamped on the coin. That caught my attention. Now, silver is used for trade and purchasing. You know, it's provision. Silver is used. Now, again, the double portion, of course, reminding me of the dream, double portion. But he was mining for gold. He was panning for gold, not silver. So here's what God was showing me. Think of silver as provision. Think of gold as wealth. It's the difference of having provision and having wealth. All right, you with me? Now, the Lord said to me when he spoke to me when I had those coins, he said, in this season, I'm going to bring great prosperity to my people, to the ones who know my name, my voice, and follow my spirit, thus panning for gold. Someone is hungry, looking for it. He said, they will be, now again, there's a prerequisite of the requirement to find that gold. He's telling us, right? You with me? He's telling me, are you with me? Hungry for it, looking, listening to the Lord, who hears my voice. They will be as the ones who come out of Egypt. As Psalms 105 said, verse 37, he brought out Israel laden with silver and gold, and from among their tribes no one faltered. Laden means all you could carry of silver and gold. They will be in this season prospering with supernatural strategies and favor ideas. Now, when they were brought out of Egypt, they were carrying the world's wealth into the kingdom of God's function and purposes. Let me say it again. In this season, you will be carrying the wealth of the world into the kingdom and the purposes of God. You'll be carrying it. You'll capture it, like mining it, panning it. You're going to find it. You're going to be handling it, okay? So, for instance, panning for gold is a purposeful event. You don't stumble across it. You have to purposely look for it. And that's an analogy of what he told me, remember, that those who hear my voice, so those that want to capture that moment will take the time to hear his voice and follow his leading in this season. What season is that? In this season of birth pains, in this season of great fear and chaos, in this season, okay? Now, to give you an idea, he said this. Well, let me say it this way. Panning for gold kind of looks like you would do right now if you thought there was a silver coin under your seat. If there was a gold, a silver 1 ounce coin under your seat, you would probably reach under there and find if it was there or not. Now, you'd be very purposeful about that. You guys are crazy. Saturday night people. Saturday night online campus. Saturday night people are just. Well, I guess you don't want it bad enough. All right, that's a good illustration. Thank you. For those that hear my voice, God said, and do what I say, they shall have. But you're all just sitting there because there's still a silver coin out there. You found it? You found it? All right. Okay, very good. Now, you're not going to find the silver coin sitting down and dreaming about it. If you're going to hear God's voice, you're going to purposely desire it. In this season, there was prerequisites, pre-qualifications. If you want to handle the world's wealth on behalf of the kingdom, he said, you have to hear his voice and you have to be willing to be led by his spirit, right? Did you hear that? Yes. That takes a change. It means you're going to react to that. You all got up and did something. You kind of, you know, you had to get up and do something different, right? You had to say, yes, I will do that. I want that. The Lord said this to me as well. He said, even if America does not repent, now, of course, we pray for our leaders. We pray for America. He says, you will prosper irregardless if you put the Lord first and serve him with your whole heart in this season. Now, again, the Bible teaches us prosperity already. You don't need a prophetic word to tell you you're going to prosper, right? But in this season, he's saying this is going to be extraordinary. People are going to have extraordinary ideas, concepts, supernatural strategies that are abnormal. And we need to understand that. And just as it was supernatural, the plagues that came upon Egypt did not affect the people of God in Goshen, so will it be in this season for those that hear his voice. We're moving forward now. Now, the beginning of 2022, last year, I had another dream. And again, I'm leading you on this journey to get where we're at today, okay? All right. Because you know that in 2020, that's when this season began. That's when it all began to change, right? So we're taking you from that point forward. In this dream, I saw the word contend, which is what we're kind of talking about tonight. Contend. And then I saw a picture of the communion table, and the word covenant was spoken loudly in my dream. What would that tell you? You have a covenant, which is a legal agreement. You stand in a legal place with God, legally. And remember, God told me that I was to go preach, teach his covenant of financial blessing to the nations, remember? But you have that covenant which is simply the promises of God. You have the promises. And they're all yes and amen. They're all yes and amen. See, they're all yes. No begging required. They're yes. I got to get that across to, I tell you, people need to get that. They're all, stop begging. They're already yes. All right. Now, contend means to struggle to surmount a difficulty or danger. But we think of a struggle, we think of something negative or hard, but this is not what God was saying to me. He was saying we contend, meaning that we engage and he backs it up. Let me say it again. We don't bear the weight of the struggle. Our objective, our assignment is to engage, bringing his anointing into that situation so that he can do the work. He will back it up. Does that make sense? So we're contending legally. We have the covenant. We contend in a situation, but he shows up to back it up. It's not that we have to contend in our flesh, our own strength, but we do have to engage like the priest when they were crossing the River Jordan. Nothing happened till their toes touched the water. Then it parted. I think sometimes we want it to part first, right? Let's see, that's pretty dangerous out there. It's a pretty big flooding river. I don't want to go in there, right? No, we can't do that. He's saying we can't do that. We judge it by his word. He follows his word. So we don't judge it by circumstances. We're not to grow back in fear. Think of the Battle of Jericho. The walls fell. They didn't have to fight anyone, right? Think of Gideon's battle. 300 men against an innumerable army. They didn't use their swords. Or David and Goliath used a sling, a supernatural strategy. This is what this looks like, is that you don't have to know how it's going to happen. You just know it's going to happen. You just have to, by faith, step into it, knowing God is going to back you up because you've heard his voice and he's leading you by his spirit, right? As I was praying, and this is what I was praying back in 2022 when he was telling me this, as I was praying, he said, make room for suddenly. Make room for suddenly. You know, when God called me to Albania to take the kingdom message there, you've heard the story, I won't cover it here. He put a silver ring in that offering. Remember the offering that we took there in Albania? When he spoke to me, I'm sending you to the nations to preach my covenant of financial blessing. I have that ring at home, and of course, it's a memorial to his words. It's just like your wedding band is a memorial, a memory of the words spoken by the person putting it on your finger, the promise, right? Yep. Right? That's what communion is, too, right? It's a memory. It's a remembrance that you remembered the words spoken. And so I have that ring at home to remember his words that he sent me. I have his anointing to do that, and he said he'd cover the cost. I like that part, but I remember that. I need that, you know? So when Drenda and I, when I came back from Albania, of course, I'm not going to tell the whole story, but you know, what does that mean? I'm sending to the nations, and he said, TV, right? You've heard this story. And he gave us a gold coin to anchor. He showed Peter where the money was at in the fish's mouth. I'll show you where it's at. So again, everything in the kingdom is led by the Spirit of God. It doesn't work the same way in the natural completely. We want all the answers, but he has the answer. But he can't tell you the answer because Satan will pick up on it. You follow me? Satan will pick up on it. So the coin is hidden. The plan is hidden. It's only revealed when you're about to step into it. Right? You got to learn how this thing works to pick up on the strategies of the Holy Spirit. So then at the same time, you know, when he came back, God said, you know, we're building the Now Center, this facility, which is millions of dollars. And money was extremely tight. And Ron and Cindy over here were treasurers back then. They handled all that. I mean, there were weeks we had no money and bills due. And a check would show up right on time. Until you get comfortable walking into nothing, you will not be able to handle a very big assignment for God. Now, I'm not saying ignorance and foolishness. I'm only saying what God says, okay? Because you don't want to jump out without him. you know, not be happy story. But interesting enough, God gave me a ring in Albania, remember, to reaffirm that he has it covered. And they can attest this fact. Rings began to show up in the mail. They began to show up in service. I'm not talking about one ring a month, or I'm talking about rings began to show up. Diamond rings, wedding band rings, rings began to show up. In fact, I even took one of them down to Cindy's office, and I put it right in front of her on the bulletin board so she could see it, because she's looking at the books. I needed something, as she looked at the books, to remind her that God has this. You need the same thing in your bill drawer, something that reminds you. Remember, I put that right in front of you. Still have it. But rings began to come in. And so God was reaffirming his promise. You know, I didn't catch on right away, but they kept coming, right? It's like, okay, I get it. Yeah, you'll cover it. Even though at this moment it looks like it's a little scary, you got it covered, and it was. Now, the money came in. Now, so that's why today, if you're a partner with the ministry, you get what? We send you a ring. Because that's how we started the ministry. Now, we launched the Journey campaign. The Journey campaign, it was an outreach campaign. Of course, we needed more facility space. It was about provision. It was about translations. It was about the nations. It was essentially a vision fund. We had maxed this place out. We had 400 homeschool students. I mean, we just needed extra room. And we had no money. We didn't know how would we be able to afford. Now, we began to gather some money, but not enough to pay for the addition. In fact, when we had the first, offer, I guess, the price? What do you call it? The bid? Okay, so it was like 15 million, but then in a matter of, 5 months, it went to 36 million or something. And then it went to 50 some million. So obviously, we said, okay, we got to back up because we need space faster than that. And interesting enough, during that time, this is true, I'm telling you all this stuff, every single week, I don't know who did this. Someone would put 1 ounce silver coins in the offering every single week. I have no idea who did it. You know, I don't know why they just didn't dump all of them in at once. But the Lord was leading them. Every single week, they gave 2 silver coins. And then, pow, a $15 million building was given to us. Now, we added some money to it to rehab it, but that's what I'm saying. You don't have to know how God's going to do it, but make room for suddenly, okay? And, of course, now we have our K-12 there and different things like that. But every week, it's just interesting, every week, 2 silver coins. Now, you know what I just told you silver coins meant to me, right? There's provision in the dreams, a double portion. There's provision. And he's staying with the same mode of operation the entire time. Rings, silver, you know. So we obeyed the Lord. We launched our K-12 school. And we said, as you know, the camp, $1.7 million camp we bought this year. You probably, well, you had the, no, we didn't have the money for it. I understand. Money follows vision. Money follows, you know. But it's interesting. Now, the school, when you were launching a school, you know, we're paying for it, right? The tuition doesn't pay for it. You got that? It's not big enough. You know, so, you know, we're kicking in $300,000 or $400,000 to get it off the ground this year. And so you could look at that like, well, you know, that's an investment, right? It's growing every year. It takes time to do that. But you still count the cost. It's like, okay, yes, we'll do that. You want the camp? He said, I want that camp. Yeah, okay, we'll do that. And I haven't got a ring in, 2 or 3 years. but last month I got a ring. What's going on? He doesn't change. He's faithful. He's going to remind us. Now, this is my story. You have a story as well. And I want you to win in your story. Joshua 6:20, when the trumpet sounded, the army shouted. This is at Jericho. At the sound of the trumpet, when the men gave a loud shout, the wall collapsed, and everyone charged straight in and took the city. Now, I had a series called The Walls Are Down. The walls are down. But for some reason, a lot of people aren't charging in to take the promises. They're not panning. They're not wanting to pan for gold. You know, they're just sitting idly by. And this is the stats that prompted the message tonight, because I was reading some stats. The CNBC survey polled 4,000 people, U.S. adults, and 74% of them said they're stressed about their personal finances. Three quarters of Americans. And it said that half of the Americans, 61%, consider themselves to be living paycheck to paycheck. Now, we all start someplace, so don't misunderstand what I'm trying to say here. Everyone starts somewhere. But paycheck to paycheck doesn't lend much room for vision. Usually, the vision for paycheck to paycheck is to escape the survival thinking and go to McDonald's and go to Walmart, which is okay if you like that. But most people go to Walmart and McDonald's because they don't want to spend thousands of dollars. You know, they got to make it fit. And that's okay. Everyone starts somewhere, right? Okay. But it should change. I mean, I'm talking about you have it coming, right? 7 in 10 Americans workers say they would need an annual salary of more than $100,000 a year just to survive happily. Epoch News, 70 million more credit cards accounts open now than in 2019. 70 million more credit card accounts have been opened since 2019. Consumer debt has risen to $17.6 trillion. Thriving Wallet, a website. 90% of Americans say that money has a severe impact on their stress level. And 65% report feeling that their financial difficulties are piling up so much that they can't see past them. I'm not talking about 5%, 10%. I'm talking about the majority of the people that live in America, and I don't want you to be one of them. That's what I want to make sure. I want to make sure you're not one of them, because we got work to do. And if all you're doing is thinking about paying the bills, I mean, you got to get past paying the bills. That's just survival, right? Because you have an assignment. We got things to get done, right? I mean, we got to get past paying for food and bills and rent and houses. I mean, you're supposed to, we got assignments here. As your pastor, we got to get this done. Now, I'm not speaking condemnation, because you know my story. I lived there a long time. But as your pastor, I've got to help you if you're there to see past this and tap into the legal right you have in the kingdom to live above that. Now, number one, of course, I spend hours teaching on these lines. Number one, you got to learn how the kingdom of God works. And it works completely different than the earth curse system, where you've been trained in that mode, robbing Peter to pay Paul and surviving and learning how to live on little and how to, you know, you've been trained to live in the earth curse system. Sweat, survival, labor, that's how you were trained. But you've got to learn how the kingdom operates. I'm not covering that tonight. But my books, you need to be a student of the kingdom. You need to make a decision, I'm going to become a student of the kingdom. So I'm going to mention a couple things tonight, hopefully to get you started. But I know you've all heard Drenda's halibut story in Alaska. She caught this big halibut, remember? And put the picture up there if you don't know this. I won't tell the story. But there she caught this giant halibut, where she told the guy, it had a big halibut derby, and she told the guy, I'm going to win the derby so that God gets the glory. It was a Christian-owned business. And she doesn't know how to catch a halibut. She doesn't even know the bait to use, or what size hook, how deep. She knows nothing about it. But there it is. And she said, now she didn't know anything. She says to the guy that owns the company, I'm going to win the halibut derby. If you win the derby, you get your picture, that picture in the paper, you get a check, and you get recognized all over the Kenai Peninsula as the winner of the derby. But she doesn't know anything about halibut fishing. But she walks in and, quite frankly, shocked me. I was like, what are you saying? But I know she's a woman of God. I know she had a plan. And so she went out and she caught the fish. She caught the derby. That's the derby winner. She got her paper and her picture in the paper and got her check, and she was the derby winner. And that's great. And that's, you know, that's there's a big story with that. But here's the point I want to make. You say, I'd like to catch fish like that. I went over to your house. You say, I'd like to catch fish like that. I go into your house, and there you are. You got your bathtub filled up. You got a bobber and hook, and you're waiting. What are you doing? I want to fish like Pastor Dren is. I'm going to catch me a halibut. I would think you are nuts. But that's what people are doing. That's what they do. You can't catch a halibut in a bathtub. Now, I'm not saying what I'm about to say in any belittling fashion, because we all start somewhere. Start, not end. Not grow complacent. I'm saying start, okay? Well, Pastor Gary, you know, I'm believing for some overtime pay down at Walmart. And that's okay. Not against that. As long as you're not satisfied to stay there forever. You with me? Because if you're going to try to catch a halibut, you got to change ponds. You got to go to the ocean. Bathtub's not going to work. If you want to produce thousands of dollars, you know, Walmart's not going to give it to you. I get out here. Friends, you've heard me say this. Stop looking for money for survival and start praying to create wealth, opportunities, favor. Start asking the Holy Spirit. We'll get here in a minute. But now, Deuteronomy chapter 28. Let's turn there in the Bibles. Yes, I am going to get the Bible out in this whole discussion. Verse number 8. Now, I've told you that the promises of God are listed here in Deuteronomy chapter 28. You say, Pastor, that's Old Testament, but you know I've told you before, this is the blessing of Abraham, which has been grafted. You've been grafted into the blessing of Abraham. Every single promise here is yours. That's Galatians 3:13. It says that. All right, the Lord will grant that the enemies who rise up against you will be defeated before you. They will come at you from one direction, but flee from you in seven. The Lord will send a blessing on your barns and on everything you put your hands to. Listen, I can tell how big your vision is. Show me your barn. Show me your barn. I can see how big your vision is. Show me your barn. What are you preparing to capture? Where are your nets? What can God fill? That's what it says. He's going to fill your barns. So show me your barns. What do you anticipate? What do you believe him for? What are you capturing? What are you preparing for, right? Now I'm starting to meddle. It's okay, though. The Lord will bless you in the land he is giving you. He'll bless you whatever you put your hands to. Whose choice is that? Yours. That's your choice. All right? Verse 9, the Lord will establish you as his holy people. Let me ask you, is this the nation of Israel we're talking about here in 28? Do they already have covenant? Yes. Are they already God's people? Are they established? No. They're coming into the land. I will establish you. They're not established. They're God's people. They have his promises. But they're not established, right? Just say yes. They're not established until what happens? I mean, in the land. This is the earth realm. In the earth realm, the Lord will establish you as his holy people as he promised you on oath. If you keep the commands, Lord your God, and walk in his ways, then all the peoples on earth will see that you are called by the name of the Lord, and they will fear you. The Lord will grant you abundant prosperity. Again, this is not a condemning message. I'm just trying to help you. You cannot be established not owning anything. Eventually, the legal owner will come and try to take it away. I mean, there's nothing wrong with starting renting a house. There's nothing wrong starting renting, you know, having payments on a car. But stop making the payments. Who's going to come and take it? The owner. If you want to be established, you have to believe God to own things. You want to believe God for the blessing of the Lord on your life. You want to, but see, here's the problem. People get comfortable living that way, and that's normal then. They're okay fishing in the bathtub. They get accustomed to it, that survival thinking. It's just, okay, we got our bills paid this week. That's good. And that is good. Thank God for that. But there's more. Everyone say, there's a whole lot more. And in this day and age, well, let me finish the, get it here. Okay. Now, here's the key. Who is establishing them? What does it say? Who is doing that? The Lord says, I want to establish you. I will establish you. I will establish you. How is he going to do that? Let's go up a couple sentences. The Lord will send a blessing. Let's see here. I got to find it. Oh, let's get 9. The Lord will establish you as his holy people as he promised you on oath. That was given to Abraham. If you keep the commands of the Lord your God and walk in his ways. Now, we can interpret that many ways. If you keep the commands or if you do what he says. How is he going to establish you? By giving you creative ideas, supernatural strategies. If you'll do what he says, is what he said earlier in the message, right? He said, for the people that hear my voice, led by my spirit, let me paraphrase, do what I show them to do, they are going to be prospering in this season in a very big way. That's just what he's telling me. You're not established when you're broke because every little whiff of fear sends you into a dizzy spin. Anytime something breaks, you get all emotionally upset. Established means like a 100-year-old oak tree. The wind can try to blow it down, but it can't even touch it. You're established. No one can move you off of that property. No, it's you own it. You're established. Threats don't mean anything because legally you know you have legal rights. It's yours, right? I have an older RV. I think it's a 2012 model. And I took it into the shop to have it fixed this past week or so. And I haven't been to that shop for years. But the same guy owns it. And had to have some minor repair to it. Hey, I said, I haven't seen you in here for a long time, Gary. I said, I don't drive old cars anymore. So I told him. I don't mean to be so blunt. I'm just... I was nice to him. I mean, he's a nice guy. It just came out. It's like, and old cars are fine, you know? I mean, it's okay. Everyone starts there. But, you know, when I got a family to drive around town, I don't want to break down everything. I lived there. Yes. Sending, drinking the kids across country, across the town, you know, not knowing if the car will make it across town. There's no way to live, you know? Jeez, I remember all kind of stories like that. My only possible solution was I had maybe $100 left on my Firestone card. That's all I had, you know, just, you know. Credit was the only thing that could help us at that time. I had no money. Where's your nets at? Now, the Bible says he'll bless the work of your hands. Is that what it says? All right. And you built a barn, and you put your hand to something. So you're designing your life. So the blessing to your hands, you have a choice, you know. You could have a 10 by 10 foot piece of property and grow some tomato plants. Put them on your sandwiches. But someone who thinks different, after they taste that tomato, thinks, wait a minute, everyone needs tomatoes. And he'll take the same principles, the same law of the kingdom you're using for those 10 plants, he'll think different. He'll think, oh, my
goodness, those are pretty good tomato plants. Because they're blessed. They're under the, you know, your hands. They're blessed. You got, you know, great tomato plants. He'll go out and plant 3,000 acres of tomato plants and become a millionaire. What's the difference? Same laws, same kingdom, same blessing. How he thinks. How he thinks, or she thinks. Anyway, I told you a story. It just kind of blew me away one day. I was on the plane. I told this story many times. Sitting next to this guy, and we got a little conversation going, you know, and what do you do? I told him what I do. I'm a pastor, and about my company, and, you know, kind of our story. And then I said, what do you do? He goes, well, I own a bakery. You know, I launched a bakery 2 years ago. I live in Mount Vernon. So when you say bakery, I'm thinking of what I see around there. You know, wedding cakes, cookies, you know, little bakery store, right? So I said to you, I said, how's it going? He said, this is 2 years old. We did like 20-some million last year. I about fell out of my chair. Obviously, this guy wasn't owning a bakery because he liked to cook bread. He liked to make different kind of bread. Money. I'm not kidding. I mean, you see what I'm saying? His approach was completely different. The bakery was a means to an end. It wasn't the end. And this is what people do. It's like, we can grow 10 little tomato plants and we'll be happy here. You know, cook a sandwich for you every day and have a good time. But all along, the same covenant, the same promises are producing, but you're the one that has the decision. Now, the Bible says this also. Let me just go there again to Deuteronomy 28. The Lord will open the heavens, verse 12, storehouse of his bounty to send rain in your land in season and to bless all the work of your hands. Second time he said it. You will lend to many nations but borrow from none. The Lord will make you the head. How does he do that? Ideas. He's going to make you the head. The head has the ideas, the creative thoughts. See, if you're not engaging the ideas, see, most people are so overwhelmed with just survival, the ideas go because you're already so maxed out and overwhelmed and your to-do list never gets done, you do not want another idea. And you've never computed the fact you could restructure your processes to handle that. You say no before you ever think yes. The Lord will make you the head and not the tail. If you pay attention to the commands of the Lord your God that I give you this day, carefully follow them, you'll always be at the top, never at the bottom. Do not turn aside from any of the commands. So here we same instructions. Do what he says. Ideas. It's not fun to be a tail friend. You just kind of hang around. Life happens to you. You don't do life. If you don't like the sights and sounds of being a tail... You need to hang around some other people. Hang around people that have vision. You need to start talking vision. You need to start talking and praying in the Spirit and saying, God, give me a revelation of something I can do. I need to operate in a mode of unlimited potential. That's how you are made. That's how you think. That's how your spirit operates. You are created to live with unlimited potential. That is how you were created. You were created to create. That's how you're made. And when you create, it's unlimited potential. Right? Say, Lord, show me where it's at. Show me where it's at. Stay there and pray in the Spirit till you get it. Don't give up. Say, Lord, show me what I got to do. Stop applauding mediocrity. Everyone's afraid to clap. Okay. You have to think different, friend. This is like, it's like a tilt, like a pinball machine. It's like, you got to tilt. You got to let it tilt. This doesn't make sense. Stop waiting for God to do something when he's already given you the authority to do it. You know, I'm waiting for my house to sell. Command it to sell. Sow a seed and call it done. Don't sit there and just wait for stuff. You know, make it happen. Command the creative ideas to come. Pray in the Spirit. Put a draw on the kingdom. You know, prophesy to it. Prophesy to your tomorrow. Prophesy to your job, your opportunities. Prophesy what the word says. You're not prophesying. The word has so many promises. Pick one out. Speak it over your life each day. Take authority over the natural realm. Tell the storm to stop. Tell the devil to get back, right? Tell those sails to come in Jesus' name. Take authority. Fill your nets. Where do I fish? How do I fish? What do I fish for? When do I fish? Don't sit there and think, I don't know how. Obviously, if you knew how, you would have done it already. God knows. Now listen, here's the whole key. In these unstable times, God wants to show you off as an oak of righteousness and someone who's stable. When the world is shaking, people are looking for someone to grab onto that is stable, established. We're out of time. Yeah, I know. I got to have a vote. Everyone has to say yes. I can't by one guy. Okay. All right. Who's that back there? He's the one, so after service, I'll just take a couple minutes. All right. Thinking difference. Here's the key. Here's a key principle. Stop looking at your paycheck and start looking how it was produced. What I mean by that is, you get a paycheck. How did you get it? Why did you get it? What produced it? Okay. Not you being there, not you working there. That did produce it, but how was it produced? All money's created in the marketplace. So how was it produced? How did that paycheck get to you through the hands of your employer? What I'm trying to say is you're looking at the wrong end of the equation. It's like watching a guy with a supercar going on the road and thinking, man, I'd love to have that car. You're looking at the wrong thing. You're looking at the end of the equation. You need to look at the driver. He has the answer, not the car. You need to find out what the driver knows, not the details about the car. You can pick any car you want if you figure out what he knows. If you figure out how your company got there, then maybe you could have a company. You see what I'm saying? Don't look at the end result. Don't look at the paycheck. If you're looking for creative ideas, you want to analyze, how did this company get here? How do they do payroll? How do they do inventory? How do they do what they do to get me here at this paycheck? You've got to become a student to see the opportunities. Is that making sense? Now, we've all told the sad story of 2 Kings chapter 4 multiple times, and we usually ran out of tissues, and we do, about the widow that the two sons were going to be put in slavery to pay the debt, correct? Remember the story? And she goes to the prophet, and the prophet says, I'm broke. Is that what he said? Nope. See, he knows if he does not teach her how the kingdom operates, she'll be back at his door the next month and the next month and the next month and the next month. That was good. Is that right? Unless you know how to fish, you're going to be begging for fish every month, or begging your rent, or begging whatever it is until you learn how to create that. So the prophet says, well, what do you have? And her response is what most people say. We have, and she emphasizes it, like how she didn't say just nothing, nothing at all. That means hopelessness. There's no possibility for me. I have, right? Done. Hopeless. Nothing. At all. Except a little bit of oil. The prophet says. Go gather pots, not a few. Now there's the sentence that she missed. The last part. Oh, they're going to give me a loan. That's wonderful. Now, it wasn't really a loan, but I'm just made that as kind of a temporary. You would do that like without thinking through people. Oh, short-term thinking. So I'm trying to get across. Short-term thinking. Go gather pots. And she's probably so excited to hear him say that. And not just a few, probably didn't hear him say that. Because she was so excited that here's her answer, right? And because she was so under pressure to get these kids out of this debt situation, she couldn't hear the rest of the sentence. How do I know that? Because she gathered just enough pots. When the oil stopped, send me another one. See, when it started working, she wanted it to work, but she already put the cap on it, didn't she? And so what happened? You think she was excited? I don't think so. I don't think she was excited. I think she was upset with herself. Because, as I've said many times, she would have gathered every pot for weeks if she knew the potential that she had. And so will you. If you can somehow understand the potential that you have, you will think past survival, think past, and begin to think differently about your future and allow the Holy Spirit to give you creative ideas that are bigger than you, that you can't do yourself, and you will embrace them. When you step into them, God will be there, and he will show you a new future. And that's, we'll stop there. All right. Let's stand to our feet tonight. See, Pastor, why did you go through all that? Because God told me that in this season, he wants to confuse the wise with his people prospering to an extent that is puzzling to them. There's trouble everywhere, right? And here you are having the best year of your life. And they're going, how? I don't understand that, man. It's like, my business is down 50%. For the display of his splendor. Display of his splendor catches your attention. You don't have to look at the stars to find them. They find you. You don't say, oh, I got to find a star. No, they catch you. They catch your attention. They glitter. See, that's what God says. For the display of his splendor. People go, what? And specifically, he said he wanted to do it in this season. If all was chaos. And I don't want 70% of my church just barely surviving. I'm not, we got promises and covenant. Now, hang with me. You can learn. I mean, but I don't want. I would count that as a failure on my part if I celebrated that fact. And again, we all start somewhere. I'm in no way trying to make anyone feel bad because I've lived. You know my story. I lived there, a long time. But we've got work to do. Got things to get done. And I want to be a cheerleader and a coach to help you get there. Bow your heads with me tonight. If you're here and you say, Pastor Gary, man, I tell you what, I need God. I need the Lord in my life. And it's easy, you know, it's not the law, it's not religious. You don't have to jump through hoops. But you do with a sincere heart need to call on the name of Jesus, give him your life, make him your Lord. Turn away from evil. The Bible says, whoever calls on the name of Jesus shall be saved. So before we leave tonight, we're going to all pray out loud, even online. We're going to pray with you too. If you would say, that's me, Pastor Gary, I need to call on the name of Jesus. I need to know him. I need to know how life's supposed to work. We're all going to pray together. But just you say, include me in this prayer. Just stick your hand up. Just stick it up really high. You're here and you say, I want to be part of this prayer. Raise your hand. I see some hands up. You're going up. Yeah, don't wait for life to fall farther. How can you tell? Do not delay the answer. Man, God loves you. He's not against you. He's trying to help you. Online, you can raise your hand as well and say these words with me. Say, Father, you said in your Bible that if I call on the name of Jesus, you'll receive me. You'll make me brand new on the inside. Fill me with your Holy Spirit. Teach me how to live life your way, the kingdom way. And I need that. So today I say yes. Write my name in the Lamb's Book of Life. Today, Jesus, I make you the Lord of my life. And I receive your goodness. Amen. Amen. If that was a sincere prayer of yours, I want you to look at the screens. We have, thank you, amen. We have a free download for you. If you raise your hand, we have a free download. And I want you to attend Kingdom Track. That's your next step here at Faith Life. Kingdom Track. It's there. It's after the service. It's after every Saturday service and the 12 o'clock service. We have a meal there for you, but it's 4 weeks of an orientation to what is Pastor talking about, the kingdom, how does this work, you know, is this really real, and all that stuff. So I say, give us a year. Just, if you're kind of like scratching your head, just give us a year, and we'll help you sort it out. Amen. You can have a seat, and Pastor Drina is going to join me up here. Amen. You look so pretty tonight.
Good word. Thank you. Good word. Wow. I'm just thinking about the journey.
Yeah.
The whole journey of this whole thing.
Yep.
You know?
It's not done.
I don't think many of you know where we came from. We try to tell you, but I was sitting there thinking, I went from believing God to find things at garage sales and the Goodwill. That's where I started at.
And they showed up.
Yeah. God was faithful there, right?
Yes.
And then, you know, Odd Lots, we used to call it. It's Big Lots now. I think they decided to remarket themselves. And Schottenstein's, and then, you know, Macy's and TJ Maxx and Marshall's. And I can remember him taking me on my birthday 1 year. The new store had just opened that we knew nothing about called Nordstrom. And he took me there to shop for my birthday. Went up the escalator. I looked at the prices. I went back down the escalator.
I was going to buy her an outfit for her 40th birthday.
Yeah, so wasn't that long ago. Anyhow. And we went to Macy's and we walked around.
We left Nordstrom.
Yeah, we left,
Nordstrom. You found something you liked.
Well, I saw something immediately
you
I liked.
You found something you liked.
But I looked at the price tag and I went, no. Yeah. And we went down the escalator. We went to Macy's. We went through the store. We looked at everything. And he looks at me, and all of a sudden he stands still, and I see tears running down his face. And he said, we're going back to that other store. You deserve that, and we're getting that for you. And I felt like Cinderella. We went back there, and we're both crying. Yeah. And so sometimes your vision has been so down here. You've been beat up by life, or you know your childhood, or whatever situations, and you can't see yourself. If you'll start to do what he said and declare and decree what God says, even if it's hard to believe it, even if it doesn't seem like you'll have it, one of two things will either happen. You'll keep declaring it and decreeing it until it comes to pass, or you'll decide you can't speak it because you just don't believe it and you'll walk away from it. Which one are you going to do? Right? So if you keep declaring what God says, you will have what he says. And it doesn't matter if it takes you longer or you get it faster or you get it slower. Doesn't matter. Hopefully, from our mistakes and our experiences, like parents, spiritual parents, we want to help you get, you know, not make the mistakes we made, right? Any parents in here, you don't want your kids to make your mistakes.
It's not about materialism, but you can't receive that from your husband.
It's about identity.
We're going to have a hard time receiving from God.
It's about identity.
Right? It's identity.
Yes.
How we view ourselves.
Yes.
But they got shoes on you. They bought your socks. I think they got your underwear. Everything was brand new. Panties, right? Girls, I don't know.
She's told me so many stories right now.
She's taught me that. It's not underwear. Anyway, never mind. Change topic. Anyway, you get the idea.
It's Saturday night. You want to hear a story? One time.
No, we don't need to do that. We don't need to do that.
It's such a funny story, though.
Well, to you, it is.
Please let me tell them. They want it. Do you want to hear?
I got to ask the guy back there.
he said, no, he's done. He doesn't want any embarrassing story from Pastor.
Okay.
What's up? Anyway, okay. I'll just make a fast version of it, okay? Okay. He and another gentleman that was the children's pastor at the time decided they were going to go shopping for their wives together at Christmas. They went to Meijer to shop, of course. And they went and they both decided, you know what? Let's buy our wives some underwear.
You said underwear.
Okay.
That's what they said. Yeah, right. That's not what I said. That's what they said. They asked this lady, and neither of them knew what size underwear their wives wore. So they asked a lady working there, where the underwear? And she says, what size do you need? And he says, I don't know. What size are you? My wife looks about your size. So, and then the other guy bought his wife some huge underwear.
Well,
huge.
He didn't know it. We were in the checkout line.
They were like 10 sizes.
We were in the checkout line. I went first, and I see him sit us down there, and they're size 52. And I said, I don't think that's not right.
So the motto of the story is, if you want to, you got to learn from someone, right? He at least asked the lady what size he needed to buy. The other guy bought his wife this huge underwear, and she was a little late. And the other thing they bought us, it was so cute. They bought us these hands-free things because we like to talk on the phone so that we could put them on our headset so we could talk on the phone. I was like, this is great, Gary. We got a lot to learn here. Anyway.
That's the day I learned the difference of
That's why we started doing marriage conferences.
Yes.
The very first time I said, let's do a marriage conference.
Wait a minute, you said one story.
Okay.
Let's not keep going here.
Just the last one.
My glasses are fogged up.
His glasses are fogging. Anyway, I said, let's do a marriage conference. And he goes, I don't know anything about marriage. I said, that's why we need to do one. So
that was the first year of marriage, by the way.
Yes.
And I didn't know anything about marriage. That's true.
Well, anyway, okay. We've come a long way. And so can you, if you apply what this word says and
that's
you
right.
search it diligently, you'll find every answer you need to life. Amen?
Amen.
And God will stretch your vision and he will give you grace to yep. accomplish exactly what he said. And if
Amen.
He could do it for us, he could do it for
what,
anyone.
That's a moth.
Okay. If he can do it for us, he can do it for anyone. I believe God chose us because he wanted to make the foolish things wise. And he wanted to show people, this is what can happen for you. So you can listen to our stories and go, I'm not that dumb. If God could do that for them. But the difference is we have to learn to listen to him. Amen?
That's right.
So, sorry, I don't know. We have a moth attack in here going on. Anyway, we command you in the name of Jesus to get out of here. Anyway, real quick, God loves you. That's the bottom line. The bottom line is you, the Bible says if you being good, you being evil parents know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will God give good gifts to those that love him? And also it says in another version, give the Holy Spirit. And then the Bible says it's his pleasure to give you the kingdom. He's given you all things that pertain to life and godliness. And so, anyway, you can receive at the goodwill, but there should come a day where you say, you know what? One time I went to Odd Lots.
Another story?
Yes.
Okay.
And I walked all around Odd Lots, and I kept looking, and I could find nothing. I could find nothing that spoke to me, made me get excited, made me want to buy. And I realized my vision is not here anymore. And I gotta change stores. I gotta change. And God's wanting us to go from glory to glory to glory. And that's a spiritual journey, but your spiritual journey should affect your life.
It doesn't matter what store, but if you feel like you can't shop anywhere else, that's the difference. Yeah.
You can receive from God.
Tell us about the book.
I want to tell you about a book.
While you're all getting ready for the offering coming up yet. You thought I forgot, but I didn't. So you guys can go ahead and pass the envelopes out.
Hey, you would give money to a comedy club. We gave you a comedy club. No. Okay. Jake and the Super Awesome Savior. So Halloween is coming up. We have a mandate as a ministry to reach the lost. We do. And I have such a passion, and I believe it's God's heart to reach the youth and the children. So on Halloween evening, October 31st, and on November 3rd again, we're going to do what is an edgy outreach. It's for gamers. It's for kids that are into anime and emo and everything else, okay? It's edgy. It's got violence in it. Not anymore, probably, than your kids are seeing on their gaming, right? Not anymore. So what's going on in the culture and the world? We've got to draw them in with bait. I had to put, that's what I learned, to catch that halibut. They put this huge bait on it. I couldn't put a minnow on there and catch right? What I was trying to catch. So they put this huge bait. So fire and ice is huge bait.
Yeah.
But it won't help kids and youth if we don't get them here to see it. So October 31st, November 3rd, if you want to bring earplugs, if you want to shut your eyes, whatever you need to do, grandmas and papas and moms and dads, but get young people here. Because what they're seeing, and don't tell them you're bringing them to church, you're bringing them to a Halloween experience, and it's very violent. Tell them that. They'll come, okay? They'll come. All right, so it's bait. We're going to catch fish. We're going to fish with the right bait. So that's for reaching youth, and we're going to get kids born again. I believe we're going to see
yes,
it
amen.
Outpouring. It is an allegory yes. of the Word of God. It's an allegory of what Jesus did, but it's not churchy. It's not churchy at all. And so don't be offended. Understand our mission and why we're doing what we're doing. And we're going to see people born again. We know we've seen it before. Actually, one young man got born again that came to it years back. And he ended up in a car wreck. He was a new believer. And he went with someone he shouldn't have gone with. And they were driving. But that young man got born again. And then he acted in it. So this is what happens. A lot of the kids that get born again from it want to become part of the cast and crew. And then they get discipled and they grow and their life is changed. And so that's why this house over here that we have a transition home is called Michael's House. It was named after Michael. Michael got born again. Filled with God's Spirit, acting in fire and ice, and he's in heaven today because of that production. So, secondly, we have a book called Jake and the Super Awesome Savior. It has a QR code in it. It's a great story to get kids saved. We're going to give these to you. And so a lot of people say, oh, I don't celebrate Halloween. Well, we really don't either, but they do out there. So what we do is if you're in a neighborhood, an area where you can give this book to kids on Halloween, and you want to set up and go incognito and give these books to kids or give them to the kids in your neighborhood. It's a great story of the salvation. It's a fun, it's a well done. And so this is for children. So we're going to get kids, youth, children saved. But you can pick these up for free. We're not charging you for them. They cost us as a ministry, but we want to, if you'll just do some things to reach, the Bible says you'll get a reward in heaven for everyone you reach like that. So,
amen.
And every time God says, you just give a cup of water in the name of the Lord, you'll not lose your reward. So why don't you give candy and a book to kids in the name of the Lord on Halloween and get them born again. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So we're just all giving right. you some ways to reach people.
Stand with me. Stand. We're going to.
We apologize. We kept you so late.
No, it's his fault right there. That guy back there.
He's one of the teachers at our academy.
Yeah. I wonder how long his classes are. I don't know. All right. Okay. Lay your hand on that envelope. Or however you're giving, your
Thank
device,
you, Jesus.
You're online, lay your hand on your device. Say, Father,
Father,
I honor you tonight.
I honor you.
I love
tonight.
You.
I love you.
It is a privilege to sow into the kingdom.
It is a privilege to sow
into
the kingdom.
And be part of the people business with you.
And be part of the people business with you.
Now, I thank you for your promises.
And I thank you for your
that
promises.
That
if I give,
I shall receive again.
I shall receive again.
And I honor you for it in Jesus' name.
And I honor for it in Jesus' name.
Amen. Our prayer team's coming forward tonight. Love to pray with you if you'd like prayer. And I'm going to ask Pastor Trina to dismiss us tonight.
Can we just take a moment and pray for Israel? Amen.
Yeah.
Father, we just pray right now for Israel and for all of the people
yes.
there, God. We know there's fear, there's some terror going on in all kinds of situations. We pray
yes.
for the peace
Amen,
of
Jesus.
Jerusalem. We pray, God, for your people there. We pray
yes.
for salvation. And we thank you, God, you show yourself mighty and strong in behalf of your people, Lord. You always do. And so we believe for that. And we also thank you for this people. We thank you that the wealth of the wicked, the Bible says, is laid up for the righteous, those who follow you and obey you, Lord, that you take the wealth from the wicked that will not follow you and that rebel and that cause harm and damage and danger, and you put it into the hands of those that love you and seek your ways. We thank you that is this people. They seek you with all their hearts, Lord. And the Bible, your word says they will be satisfied. So we thank you, Father, that you are moving in their life. They're hearing strategies from the Holy
yes.
Spirit. God,
yes.
we thank you. You're pouring
yes.
your glory out on your people
yes.
that the world will take notice that you are the
yes.
King and
yes.
will prepare their hearts and repent and get ready for the return of the King. And we thank you, God, for blessing this people. They walk in wholeness, health, prosperity. They're healed by the from the top of their head to the sole of their feet. By your stripes, they're healed. Now, thank you. They go in blessing. Lord, help us to reach a lot of children and youth in this season, God, and get them born again, filled with the Spirit, delivered from the darkness of this world, God, and praising you. In Jesus' name, we bless this people, God. Amen. Amen. You're blessed.
Amen. We'll see you next week.
Welcome back, family. Yes.
Yes.
It was good stuff, man.
Be
unfiltered.
Obedient, and he will establish you.
Yeah.
What did you have?
I'm just amazed by how everything's just...
Oh, yeah, the unfiltered version.
No holds barred. Yeah. I mean, it's just good stuff tonight, man.
Good stuff.
It was amazing. The word, we sat up on the front row to hear that word tonight.
Yeah.
And, you know, man, I just...
Between the eyes, man.
Yeah.
It was so good. And you know what? I'm not ashamed to say that. That's fine. Like... You know, we have come from the Goodwill mentality, although I do love a good thrift find. But I don't have the time so much to search through thrift stores.
Thrift stores smell weird.
I've got things to do. All right, let's not get off on that. But I'm just saying, like, I remember when we couldn't afford $100 to fix our car.
I know.
Right? And now I... You know, it's like more things have come. God's used us in greater ways, but we are not established as he was talking tonight. So it's time.
And I think for me, the longest, the thing that I've struggled with, one of the things he talked about tonight was you got to quit thinking about how he is going to do it.
Yeah.
And you just got to do it.
Yeah.
You know, how it's going to happen. You just got to do it. You know, you got to step out. You kind of use the reference of the scripture when they crossed the Jordan, the water didn't start to part until they put their toes in the water. And that's...
I think of that Indiana Jones reference where he's in the movie and there's this huge cavern in front of him and he has this prophecy or something and he's supposed to take a step and you cannot see that there is ground there to walk on. And so he just like closes his eyes and he goes and he lands on something hard and established. And then after he does that, he pulls dirt and he throws it and he sees there's a pathway all along. Mm. God has a pathway for us and it's there and it's established for you, but you have to say yes into the unknown. Go, you can do it.
Yeah. So encouraging.
Yeah.
This is what I'm sure we'll see some of you guys back in the morning for. So we welcome you to do that. It's been just an amazing night, amazing day. We start with our men's breakfast and then just a great service tonight. And we hope you feel encouraged. If it's your first time joining us online, we just want to say thank you for being here. We love you. You're so welcome to be here. And we want to tell you about FLN Connect. FLNConnect.com or the FLN Connect app is where we communicate as an online campus the most. That's where you can join our online campus page there. You can get involved in our chat that's ongoing all the time. And it's just a great way to stay connected where you can learn how to be involved in small groups and a lot of different things that are going on. We do a lot of different stuff online, monthly meetups. We'll have another one come up here in November where we meet on Zoom and we catch up with each other. We'll talk about Kingdom Track, which Kingdom Track right now online takes place at noon. So you can join us for that tomorrow for step three. But that Kingdom Track's how you get acclimated to the church. So, you know.
So many things, people.
Yeah.
It's where you need to be. That's what we just got to say. FLN Connect, the app, FLNConnect.com. Be there.
Yeah.
So you're not square.
We just bless you tonight. We thank you for you being a part of this great ministry. And we want to honor our pastors as we close today. It's Pastor Appreciation Weekend. And I know you guys weren't able to be in the room clapping for Pastor Gary and Drenda tonight, but I know you're clapping at home.
Amen.
And we just, you know, send them a message if you get a chance to just encourage them. But we just thank you for our pastors, God, the anointing that they have to step out, to say yes, to lead this body. Man, we just count it such a privilege and an honor to serve in this body. And we just bless them tonight. We just thank you for the anointing on their life that has reached so many and that's going to continue to just do a great work all throughout the world. So many people online right now have just received from this ministry, and we're going to continue to walk those things that we're learning, that Pastor Gary continues to teach us. We're going to step out in those things. We're not going to be scared. We're not going to let fear get the best of us, and we're going to step out of the boat, and we're going to do the things that you've called us to do, and we thank you for that opportunity tonight. Thank you for all these just amazing people here online, and we thank you for their hearts for you, God. Every need supply. And we just thank you for it now in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. You got to win first in your heart, in your relationship with Him. Then you win in your home. Then you win
thank
in your
you,
circle
Jesus.
Of influence. That will affect your community, and we will change the
yeah.
world. You're a part of it. We love you. Thanks for being here tonight.
Have a great night. We'll see you guys again real soon.
Bye.
Bye-bye.